If you have got an endless desire to know what should you bring within yourself when you will be pursuing your dream job as a cabin crew, here is a full description in today's video on what are the personal qualities and attributes that you should have and what are the things that the recruiters truly value and they search for in you as a candidate. My name is Julia George. I used to be a cabin crew and flew for Qatar Airways for 10 years, where I have resigned from my last work position as a cabin service director. And I'm currently studying Aviation Management Master Program at Wildau Institute of Applied Science here in Berlin. I would like to sincerely recommend to you, please do not look at me as I'm your superior, I'm your coach, or I'm someone who's above you, although I have a work experience in aviation, but rather I would ask you to look at me as I'm part of your team. Becoming a cabin crew for the airline that you're wishing for can be anything but easy, can be very challenging, and I sincerely think that if you stand in front of me, and when I say in front of me, I mean in front of my social media platform with the thought that I'm superior than you, then you might form some boundaries in which you will hesitate to ask me questions. So therefore, forget about it. I'm your team member, I'm your coach, I'm here together with you to make your dream come true, to help you to make your dream come true. Therefore, do not hesitate to hit the subscribe button over here and pop up any question that you want to know, which is related to the process of becoming cabin crew for the airline that you would want to work for. Today's video will be a complement of the cabin crew skills episodes. We talked first about the cabin crew safety and security skills. We talked about the first aid skills, and today we're gonna circle the customer service skills. So let's start. As mentioned, here is the continuation of the cabin crew skills series. And in this video, I will reveal with you what are the best cabin crew characteristics that I'm very sure that you all know, that you all have heard of. In today's video, I will try to give a complete summary on what are the cabin crew recruiters looking at when it comes to the aviation industry and recruitments for cabin crew in the aviation industry. In the first two videos of this series, we spoke about the safety and security skills, we spoke about the first aid skills, and today I think it's very important that we go on with the customer service skills, as well as when I mentioned the customer service skills, we must not forget to incorporate the two very important segments of the same, which are related to your attitude and which are related to your appearance in the same. These two components, your attitude and your appearance, they are definitely something that go hand in hand with the customer service skills that we're gonna talk about. So let's start. One of the first desired skill that I want to present to you in order to help you to secure yourself a job at 40,000 feet is called an ability to provide exemplary customer service experience with an aim to exceed customers' expectations. Your aim should be to exceed customers' expectations. If you have some kind of record of previously successfully delivering excellent customer service and satisfaction from your previous work experience, it will be considered definitely a plus point for you. And I would sincerely suggest to you that you have this as a document that will complement your CV. Take into consideration the aspect that you should display this exemplary customer service dedication in order to exceed those customer expectations, while also be able to display that you have an ability to work independently and part of a team. This is also one of the cabin crew interview questions which the recruiters will ask you and would want to know: are you somebody who prefers to work alone or prefers to work in a team? I've already spoke about it, and in fact I will leave a link below this video of the playlist of the cabin crew interview questions and the suggested answers that I have given to you in order to know in which direction every answer of the question you should go. Ladies and gentlemen, my sincere suggestion is to recommend you to learn and understand that the cabin crew role is all about establishing and maintaining customer relationships by providing that excellent customer service and promoting at the same time the airline that you would want to work for. This relationship building moment that I have mentioned starts from the recruitment process itself. This is why it is very important that you are able to understand and to create that first impression moment. I spoke about the first impression moment long ago in a separate video, and I will link, I will leave a link of that video in the description box below in order for you to facilitate that understanding of how important is the first impression. And also this is very applicable to the both the face-to-face interview and the video interview. Another skill that you should present and showcase is actually an ability to provide that excellent customer service by ensuring a welcoming environment to the passengers, as well as professionally addressing all the requests. But this is equally important to your colleagues. People should be feeling welcomed to be around you and to be in your company. You will most probably ask me now, how can you do that? How can you make that welcoming environment, right? So now let me just tell you that my videos over here and all my social media platform on my and the social media content that I create are great learning platform for you. But in order to be brilliant in everything that I share, you simply must exercise the things that I'm sharing with you. A small example, which I will share over here, is let's say somebody wants to be, or you want to be a basketball player. You can get the best coach who's going to tell you the most brilliant techniques on how to be that outstanding or that great basketball player. But in order to be noticed, in order to be skillful and to be the best in the role, you actually have to be out there and you have to be playing basketball, right? So this is the very same thing when it comes to the customer service skills. I spoke a lot about the segment of the teamwork, but please be informed that you should display an awareness that it's super important to cooperate with the rest of the crew members as well, and your ultimate goal to all of you, it should be actually providing a seamless experience, an outstanding experience for your customers, an experience in which everyone will enjoy being served and communicating with you. We come to an important part of the customer service skills, and it's called having excellent customer problem-solving skills, as well as delivering superior customer service to all your customers, as problems do arise on board the aircraft very frequently and in an unexpected manner. Now again, the question how to gain the skills will be answered by the very same example that I have shared with the basketball player example. You can be trained and coached how to solve problems, but in order to be brilliant, in order to show that you have that skills, you actually have to be out there and you have to be solving problems for customers. In other words, that you have to be working on any job that will be an opportunity for you right now. That is why it is important that you use this time during this pandemic effectively and gain some experience, which later on, that is why we say to be in a position to develop and to strengthen new skills. Another suggestion which is related to this is to ensure that while you are currently working, try to receive as much as you can testimonial letters from your customers or the company management, which later will be recognized or will be working in your favor when you will be applying to be a cabin crew. This is the moment now that you must make the best out of it if you want to later on progress and go to the career or change the career to a cabin crew. And to achieve that, you simply have to love your job, and you simply have to love your customers at the moment of any job that you are doing. Do not forget that your excellent customer service skills should actually be complemented with a very important aspect that we talk a lot about, and it's called your strong communication skills, through a very important aspect which you're supposed to be aware and know about. It's called the crew resource management. Basically, knowing that you're not alone in the aircraft. You have an entire set of cabin crew, your flight deck, that they are your resource for problem solving. How to enhance your communication skills is also a topic that I have covered on my social media platform over here on YouTube, and the link of that video, I will leave it in the description box below this video. And also, which I something that I would like to highlight to all of you ladies and gentlemen, please be aware that working as a cabin crew means working within very strict time frame, working with environmental constraints, working in an environment with the constant changes and a lot of stressful situations. Now, providing outstanding customer service for passengers, for your customers, can be challenging, definitely, but it's not impossible. If you have your skills, and I'm very sure that you will be able to develop and strengthen a lot of skills, you will obtain excellent customer training from the airline that you're going to be working for, and you will be having all your set of team members, your supervisors, your flight deck as well, who will help you together to achieve that excellent customer service that we speak about over here. Together, you are having an ability to maintain the highest level of customer service in order to ensure that comfortability to all your customers and that satisfaction that will be the ultimate goal for the airline that you will be working for. Just make sure that these terms and these skills that we speak about over here, you perhaps have opened a Word document and you have noted down and you've started to think about it and started to incorporate them in your new job, looking at your customers as something very precious and trying to achieve new goals, more goals of success on a daily basis. We're coming to an important point of this video, which I mentioned that somewhere at the beginning, and it's called your attitude. Try to display an approach or an attitude where you will ensure that enhanced customer service experience. How? By keeping a positive attitude and diffusing potential negative situations with poison humor. And these kind of situations can happen, especially during the break times of your, when your recruitment event will be happening. Display a sustainable positive attitude and showcase a professional work ethic throughout your entire presentation while you will be standing there, and ensure an execution of all the procedures, an ability that you can execute all the procedures. Now, this is how you should answer all those cabin crew questions during the interview process, actually. Also, ladies and gentlemen, do not forget that providing great customer service goes along with a positive attitude, as well as in a something called a multicultural understanding in a multicultural environment. And this is the so-called cultural intelligence. The aspect of the cultural intelligence is also written in the non-negotiable rules and regulations of the airlines. It's a very important skill that literally every candidate should have. And now it's the time that you can develop that skill if you don't have it, and you can strengthen it. And I have a video on this. I will leave the link of that video in the description box below. Now let's go to the other skills, which are customer service, and they are related to your attitude. I will briefly mention them, and as I have said, I would like you to sincerely think about it and start implementing and learning these new skills in your current job. We can go to something called promoting teamwork, promoting positive attitude, and demonstrating a polished and professional image, as well as serving as an example to others. Try using positive attitude and cheerful demeanor to address all the questions that you have been asked during the interview process that you're attending. Again, irrespective it is a video interview or irrespective it is a face-to-face interview, try to be displaying a positive attitude towards the recruiters, as well as displaying positive attitude towards the other candidates which are around you. Try to be enthusiastic when you will be assisting and talking to them if they ask you for any assistance. Try to be friendly and try to smile. We spoke about this a lot in my video about the body language. Now, try to project your positive attitude and composure at the same time, at all point of time during the recruitment process, as you will be looked as someone whether you can be or not the face of the company. Remember, they're looking also for brand ambassadors. Apply an attentive and positive attitude in order to ensure and to assure the recruiters that the other candidates are going to be enjoying your company by being cheerful, by being positive, by smiling, etc., etc. Display positive body language by maintaining that friendly and positive attitude that I talk a lot about here, but that's my ultimate goal with this video, believe me. Maintain your positive attitude and your appearance at all points during your interview, irrespective, as I have said, it's a face-to-face interview or an online interview. And again, ladies and gentlemen, do not forget on any breaks that you will be having on your face-to-face interview during the recruitment process, you have been monitored at all point of time. Now, let me inform you about something that might happen, and I think that you should take a note of this. There can be during your recruitment process, there can be candidates which will be around you, and they will perhaps irritate you for some reason. You have to ignore this with maintaining that positive attitude and being absolutely nice and pleasant to everyone, even to the ones that will irritate you, because the recruiters, if they feel that, they would definitely not like that. Now we come to the third part of the video, which I have mentioned at the beginning, which is part of your customer service skills. And this is something related to your appearance. And I think that this is super understandable, and it's a crucial point to pay attention to, just the way as I talked about the attitude as well, in order to be that outstanding candidate that I strive for over here on my YouTube channel and all my social media platforms. I will share with you customer service skills that you should display and you should pay attention to, which are related to your appearance, and do take a note of them, please. One of the first things which are related to your appearance as part of your customer service skills will be an ability or a skill where you can maintain professional appearance. You will be looked at someone whether has or not an ability to adhere to the uniform and the appearance guidelines, at the same time having into consideration punctuality and dependability. That will be something that will come a bit later. This is why it is so important to try to look as much as you can as a cabin crew that you want to work for the airline that you want to work for during the recruitment process itself, irrespective, again, it's a face-to-face interview or a video interview. Do not go on that open day or on that venue with wearing the uniform of the airline that you want to work for. That's not what I'm asking to you. I have made a video which is called the real Qatar Airways cabin crew makeup, as well as the male cabin crew grooming video, which I will leave the links of those two videos again in the description box below. And in those videos, I have clearly shared with you the guidelines which are applicable literally to all the airlines worldwide, because if you follow them, you can secure the job at Wizz Air, at Ryanair. I can guarantee you that those videos will teach you how to present a positive and professional appearance and to be looked at someone who can adhere to the uniform and appearance guidelines. So you will be seen as a candidate who actually can follow the company protocols and procedures, and every airline has its own unique protocols and procedures. And what I have shared in those videos is indeed something that is applicable to all the airlines. The guidelines are related to the conservative appearance, which is something that the airlines are having tendency to be oriented to. And it is very important to know that being well groomed is something that will help you to display and enhance that professional appearance, which will be a serious parameter on which you will be judged and looked at. Another customer service skills, or a skill which is related to your appearance, is actually displaying and maintaining that professional appearance that we talk about, and composure at the same time, while being in a position of a very professional appearance and attitude. And this sounds a bit confusing, but what I try to tell you is actually try as much as you can to be well-groomed and to be composed in whatever actions that you will be taking during your recruitment process. Do not hesitate to project an attractive professional appearance and presence. That means to smile, that means, you know, to have that proper body language, positive body language. When you will be answering all those cabin crew interview questions, when you will be communicating with the other candidates during the break, do display and maintain this professional appearance and composure at all time during the event, during the recruitment process. I keep on saying that, but I really, really, ladies and gentlemen, want to make sure that you have understand that, because you don't know at what point of time the recruiters will be around you and will see you. Please be aware and be informed that the professional appearance and the composure are an important aspect during flight incidents, during any discrepancies, and especially in fast-paced and high-stress situations, and you are looked at someone whether you can be part and you can be so-called front face for the airline that you want to work for, and you will be looked at someone whether you can be constantly, you will be actually constantly in the presence of the customers, you will be constantly in presence with your colleagues, you will be actually constantly in presence of the public view. So therefore that appearance, that composure, that professionalism that we spoke a lot over here, and you will be able to see on all these social media platforms, on the internet, just type in cabin crew appearance and you will be able to see that. That is something that the recruiters are very particular about. Last but not the least, I would like to ask you to click the subscribe button for my YouTube channel, for many videos that are coming, actually, which are also everything which I elaborate over here is related to the cabin crew recruitment process, how to help you to pass the same, how to be successful in getting that cabin crew job that you wanna work for, or be that cabin crew for the airline that you wanna work for. Perhaps at the moment, the airline that you really imagine to wear the uniform is not working, ladies and gentlemen, or it's not recruiting. This is what I wanna say. However, a storm cannot last forever. Make sure that you remember this. We might have a stop on the recruitment processes. However, we have certain airlines, and those are the low-cost airlines at the moment that are recruiting, which I sincerely suggest to everyone to take the action and apply. If you cannot get a cabin crew job, there are also jobs related to receptionists, hotels, any sort of customer service experience, whatever is available around you, just research and go out there, try to gain all those skills that we talked about in these three videos of this series of the cabin crew skills, and I'm very sure that you're gonna be successful on your next open day, assessment day, final interview, video interview. Thank you very much and have a nice day.